From what you've learned so far, does it seem that this was a series of attacks that were plotted and planned locally within Sri Lanka, or by figures who are still with the Islamic State group in Syria, who were centrally trying to coordinate this group?
By looking at the pattern of operation and the places that the leadership has traveled, so there has to be some outside involvement of some leadership or instructions.
So who's to blame for this failure to share intelligence, do you think?
This is not a blame game as such, but that the chief of the army is, I believe that everybody who is responsible for intelligence gathering and preparation of these plans and who are responsible for the national security are to be blamed, including the political hierarchies as well.
And why do you think Sri Lanka was targeted?
I could give an answer like this. Too much of freedom, too much of peace for the last 10 years. People forget what happened for 30 years. And people enjoy peace and they neglected security.
And now, going forward, can you confidently say to people around the world that Sri Lanka is a safe place for international tourists?
Sri Lanka is a country which fought for 26 years. The cases we faced at that time was more difficult and more terror than what we are facing today. We are deployed on the ground to give confidence to the public and ensure there is no violence or escalation of communal riots in this country. Have trust on the armed forces and the police of this country to bring normalcy as soon as possible.